Good morning. I'm coming to you from just above Wood End Lock number 20 on the Trent and Mersey Canal. So at the end of July, a couple of episodes ago on this news show, we announced the arrival, the impending arrival of the next SAP Developer Challenge on APIs for the month of August. We're now well into August and the challenge is underway. It's going very well. There's some great participation and comments and questions and discussions from all the participants on the SAP community platform. So if you've not started the challenge yet, it's not too late. There's been a number of tasks published. There will be some more tasks coming your way as well next week. So check out the blog post, get started. The idea of each task is that it's short, hopefully fun, and you'll learn something along the way, hopefully. Okay, well, get to it, and I'll see you on the SAP community platform.
Hey there, ABAP Studios developers. I've got some exciting news for you. In the latest ABAP release 7.93, we have a new feature called Series Enumerated Types. This feature allows you to define fixed values in your series views without the need for domains. So what exactly are enumerations? Well, they define a fixed set of values, and objects of an enumerated type can have only one of the predefined values. If you're using ABAP development tools for Eclipse, Akar ADT, a template for enumerated types is also available. The series enumerated types comes with a header annotation that allows you to add domain-specific logic. If you want to dive into the syntax and see some examples, I recommend checking out Andrea's blog post. One thing to note is that currently, you cannot define database tables with enumerated fields, but don't worry, the ABAP series team is working on a solution. They're developing a new series entity called as series table entity, which will serve as a successor to direct database tables. So for more information, be sure to check out the blog post linked in the description below.
So we had the big annual SAP Cloud Application Programming Model release back in June. So this month, as all months, we get an update to the Cloud Application Programming Model. This is a little bit more of a minor update, filling a few gaps left over from the major annual update. We see some added functionality around calculated elements, the ability to create aspects that have no inner elements themselves, and a simplified syntax for some queries. There's also some important news around Java, including support now for Spring Boot 3.1, better Postgres SQL configuration, and a few other items. As always, check out all the latest news and details about the release in the Capfire documentation. One of the things that I saw in particular was the new CDS typer functionality. So if you're into TypeScript and want to generate types for some of your CDS modeling, this is an emerging component of CAP, and there's just some new documentation that's been added. So be sure to check that out if you're a TypeScript user. And finally, on the subject of the Cloud Application Programming Model and samples, our team, the developer advocates, have just released a new sample to GitHub in the SAP samples org. This shows you how to use the Cloud Application Programming Model, but add your own non-CAP route handlers, express-based route handlers, to your application. And in doing so, we also cover a lot of JavaScript fundamentals. So if you're just getting started with the JavaScript side of the Cloud Application Programming Model, and maybe you need a little help learning some of the basic syntax, we've got some great exercises and samples in this new source code example for you. So be sure to check that out as well.
Artificial intelligence is a hot topic everywhere you look nowadays. In fact, this quarter, new product features were delivered for the AI portfolio of the SAP Business Technology Platform, helping you bring AI into your applications. You may be asking, what does this mean for me? Well, generative AI capabilities in BTP aim to improve your development experience, the way integrations are done, process automation, analytics, as well as administrative tasks. The BTP team want to learn from your expectations of AI, and if you have any, your previous experiences. They have set up a developer survey The link is in the blog post mentioned in the comments. And of course, your participation is confidential. It allows you to inform the team how they can improve your BTP experience and to help align their initiatives with your priorities and goals. This is a great opportunity I don't want you to miss. Make sure you get your feedback in before the deadline of the 15th of September.
Do you work with SAP Analytics Cloud? Do you know that the next quarterly release is coming later this month? To get you started, the product team prepared a detailed list of all the new features and enhancements. Let's have a look and check what my top three would be. So, custom widgets now support linked analysis in the same way as built-in charts and tables. Yeah, I like it. Smart Predict now provides more flexibility to evaluate the accuracy of time series forecasting models. Wow, loving it. And what else? Enhancements in APIs are now available in data exports and data import. That's cool. So check the detailed list. The link is in the description. And let us know in the comments what your top features would be.
We're happy to share the news of a new learning journey for DevOps on learning.sap.com. This free learning journey is designed for developers that want to learn some of the basics of DevOps. What are the concepts? What are the terminology? So if you're really new to the topic, this is a great course that can help you get started with lots of base knowledge. But the other aspect of this course is it's designed specifically to also talk about the BTP aspects of DevOps. So what services does SAP provide as a part of SAP BTP? And what particular DevOps capabilities and concepts do we as SAP recommend that you use when doing development on SAP BTP? So even if you're completely new to the DevOps topic or you're an experienced DevOps engineer, but you want to learn some of the BTP fundamentals related to DevOps, then this is exactly the learning journey for you.